today. From Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte, North Carolina, it's week two of the NFL on EA Sports. It's the Carolina Panthers taking on the New York Jets.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the New York Jets and the Carolina Panthers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Panther ball club as they interplay here. They come in off a good win on the road, and now they hit the home opener at 1-0.
And the offense last week, they had things humming. If you're a defensive player, you may get overshadowed a little bit, but you're really buoyed by what your offense is doing.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by the former Cal Bear, Aaron Rodgers.
And last week's loss came despite a clean game on his end, throwing the ball with two touchdowns and zero interceptions. His job this week is simple. Do it again. Continue to avoid turnovers and hope that what sunk them last week resolves itself this time around.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Michael Carter, who played nearby in college in Chapel Hill. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Well, this defense for the Panthers, terrific last week in the season opening victory.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
But just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. A throw to the flat for Carter. And he'll be brought down, but a tip of the cap on the spin move as that gives him a first down. An effective 7-yard third down conversion.
I'm not sure that that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. On second down, a run with Carter. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on 1st and 2nd down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, pulled it in. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Corey Davis, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Jets get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a 2nd one in week 2 now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. So here are the Panthers under head coach Matt Rhule. And a look at a guy, definitely got a little razzle-dazzle to him. Can do it with his arm or his legs. Their mobile QB.
I think the hope was to let him sit and learn for a bit, but he was thrown right into the fire in week one. Now we'll see what kind of lessons he's learned as he prepares for his second start in the NFL.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Over the middle, complete. It's Hubbard. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
A great job there, and that old cliche, taking what the defense gives you, comes right into play. Nothing too out of the ordinary about the throw. Just a little dump off over the middle. But what is out of the ordinary is what he did with it after the catch. Not only did he grab the ball, but how about the significant yardage he picked up after he pulled it in?
A check on the numbers last week for Hubbard. 14 carries, 103 yards, and a touchdown.
So coming off the opener where they established the run and established it well, their goal is to make sure that the trend continues and to serve notice to the rest of the league that they might be a run-first team.
Now a throw here, hauled in. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 33. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
A nice throw right there. And Charles, this is game number two in the NFL for this young rookie. His guy's getting the victory last week, and he played pretty well by most accounts. Curious, what did you see?
I saw something similar to what you described, Brandon, because I saw a guy who looked the part, a guy who was in command. Not just with the touchdown passes, but definitely looked to be in control of the offense as well. And you and I both know that's often uncommon for a rookie quarterback.
First down, they'll stay on the ground with Hubbard. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and eight. They're going to look to throw. They'll set up the screen here for Hubbard. And he'll be brought down well short of the first at about the 9-yard line. 3 yards all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. And the first play will be a field goal try. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. Gonzalez's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
So here are the Jets now to take over. They're trying to get back on track following the loss to Buffalo a week ago. But the good news, they've got the lead right now here in the football, first and 10. Here's Rodgers to throw. Open man is Uzama.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
You always worry about those smaller receivers running through that gnarly patch of land in the middle of the field. But he did a really nice job there holding on to the football and protected himself as best he could while completing the play.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here.
That's to Davis. He's got it. Touchdown, New York. Corey Davis, two catches, two touchdowns here so far, as his guys are able to extend their lead.
So after the disappointment in the opening week loss, Charles, this looks like really a completely different football team.
They sure do, and I think they realize we can't start 0-2, and they're determined to not let it happen by the looks of things here in the early going.
McCann for the point after.
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. That time, a six-play drive, and it's finished off by a New York Jets touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Panthers coming back out onto the field for their second drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material.
A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. And he will finally be escorted out of bounds down inside the 35. A big play there for Carolina. 42 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30.
Straight ahead with Hubbard. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. He'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Marshall.
And they'll work this down inside the 30.
We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. He'll drop to throw. That's going to be caught. Touchdown, Panthers. Chuba Hubbard, 29 yards. And the Panthers have got it back to within a score. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And that makes it a 14-10 ball game. The lead cut to just 4 as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Aaron Rodgers in the offense heading back out. He's got two touchdown passes on his first two drives, and he'll try again here on drive three.
Throwing now is Rodgers. Looking deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Now Rodgers. That's caught by his tight end, Uzama. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. He'll air this one out deep for Davis. And this is incomplete. Well played defensively. Nearly had the interception, but it's second down.
He's put up numbers in this one by pushing the envelope a bit whenever he could with deeper throws. But let's play a little philosophy here. Some plays it works, sometimes they're ready for you. And that time, they were on guard. Incomplete.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 35. Give them 18 on the play. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. High throw, but he makes the catch. That all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Corey Davis on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Jets will extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by McCann, up and good, and that makes it a 21-10 game. So the drive there took six plays, and it ends with a Jet touchdown. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
The last run got six, now second and four. They'll look to throw. Taking a shot here for Marshall. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. They'll throw now on the final play. He's got a man. That's Marshall. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, we'll get you back to you and Charles in a bit, but first it's time for a trip around the NFL following an eventful opening weekend.
Well, everyone's eager to resume play here in this Week 2 contest, so we push right through halftime and back at it for the start of quarter three. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And the half will begin with a touchback. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
48 yards rushing for him now on just six carries to this point.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Looking middle, and that's complete.
And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
A couple of first downs right in succession, and this is an offense that could really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
And they'll run on first down with Hubbard.
And he is going to lose yardage here. This drive starts with two steps forward and now one back. A pair of first downs and here a loss of yardage.
I know they'd love to take some heat off of that young quarterback, but so far, not much in the running game. And this won't help things either. A loss on that play.
Second and 11. Going down the middle and it's complete. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 27-yard line.
Now a give. It's Hubbard going left.
Oh, nice move. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Work to do here to avoid falling to 1-1, but this is first and 10 right now.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. So apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap the ball and then trying to get your hands into the proper position, that's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
A give up the middle, Hubbard.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
Now, that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
It's a 10-yard gain there to set him up first and goal.
Davis Price, not going anywhere. He'll lose a couple back to the 6.
A loss of 2 there, second down.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half, and that trend is continuing here.
Again, it's Davis Price,
and a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5.
Sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, second half, you're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
Man, not going
to
get much better than this for an opportunity.
Yeah, he's got it. Able to hold him to just 2 yards, and now it's 4th and goal.
Always important as a defender on third down to keep the play in front of you and make sure you don't give up enough space that they can make a move on you in the open field. Try as he might, he wasn't able to get to the first down marker. Excellent defense, good tackle.
So they were facing the deficit coming out of the locker room at intermission, and at least they're able to get the field goal to cut into that deficit.
Yeah, now your offense feels pretty good about itself, right? A little bit more up to speed coming out of the break. You turn to your defense now and say, hey, we got 3 there. We're chipping into the lead. Can you help us out? Hold them. Let's get the ball back for us.
Out on offense again. Here are Corey Davis and the Jets.
This defense, they wouldn't mind not seeing him again for a while. 3 trips to the end zone. How about that?
I think right now they would happily go to their general manager and say, is there any way you could get a trade for him? Bring him over to our team so
switch
we don't have
jerseys
to cover him anymore, because he is really having a heck of a ball game, isn't he?
Boy, he is. I don't know that mid-game trade's going to happen, but good thought.
Well, obviously, they never want to see penalties on that defense, but this one, a little bit more significant there on the downfield pass play.
And coaches preach it all the time. You can't put yourself in that kind of position if you're the defender. You've got to stay in a spot far downfield where you can play the ball without creating extra contact.
And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
First target, first catch, and a first down. On first and 10, it's Carter. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. To throw, it's Rodgers. This pass out wide to Hall. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
Well, sometimes despite the best planning, the defense actually has a plan as well, and they blanketed everyone on that play. They were able to close it down and spill him for a loss.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. That is caught at the 7. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
That is the exact right play call against that defense. So a hat tip to the offensive play caller because he won that part of the chess match. But give credit to his players as well. They won the execution part of it.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Aaron Rodgers keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Jets have opened up a 2-touchdown lead here in this fourth quarter. Well, that's certainly going to bump up the old win probability index because now it's a 2-score game here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you're taking me into that deep water now. Win probability index. This game's definitely not over. We're not looking at a 0.5% or something. It's just 2 scores. But the way that this team has played, to me, what I've seen, they absolutely deserve to win this game. They've been the better team by far throughout.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. And now this offense comes back out onto the field.
And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And he maneuvers up the middle for 3, and it's second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And now it's 3rd and 3. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Just a gain of a couple there. And it'll be 4th down.
And we're definitely getting towards the point of the game where not getting a lot of yards is secondary to keeping the clock moving. I mean, to me, that's a double win defensively. Short gain and some more time off the clock.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. There's Trimble, the tight end. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. And just a yard to go here on second down. They'll look to throw again. They'll run the screen with Hubbard. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Let's go now. Mike, you need speed.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Marshall. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. First down now, but that clock rolling. And not able to get it that time. He hit on six straight passes. Not there. Second down. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up. Second and 10. Back to throw again. Checks this down to Hubbard. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly.
Touchdown! Tommy Trimble. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Panthers are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. Gonzalez good on the extra point as this gets him back within a touchdown and a two-point conversion. A 10-play drive that time. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. And the Jets have got it. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that one. They needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have three timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it, but even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with three timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
Carter straight ahead, and give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Carter once more. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Give up the middle to Carter. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with just 70 seconds left to go in the game. Things looking much rosier for them here in week two. They work with the lead as they've got it first and 10. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Every yard they gain, getting them better and better field position. And obviously, a field goal makes this a 2-score contest. That's really all they need.
And that means for your play caller, he's not looking to the attack portion of his sheet, right? He's looking for, okay, what do we have that's going to keep us in a good spot? No lost yardage plays. Let's kick a field goal and go up 2 scores. If we score a touchdown, great, but that's not what you're really playing for.
Here's a give to Carter. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 68 yards rushing for him now to this point. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll run with Carter. And now Carter going to be stopped up short. He did not get there. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to perhaps salt this one away. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over. So it's a victory here for the New York Jets. And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just the week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.
So for the Jets, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Dallas Cowboys.